Bunny is one of the best, if not the best, descendant when it comes to clearing mobs pretty fast. Not only that, Bunny is the fastest descendant in the game. Now, for my Bunny build, this build is specifically designed based on my playstyle, which is run in and let lightning emission do the mob clearing and then shoot the remaining enemies with my gun if there are any mobs left. My build is all about survival first, since I do believe that you don't do damage when you are knocked down or dead. I also don't like glass cannon build, since it is just not my playstyle. This build is what I have been using for a very long time. I have around 900 plus hours in this game, and I have been using Bunny to grind all the necessary items in the game, from modules to descendant parts, weapon parts, and materials used in crafting weapons and descendants. Now, I'm not expecting you guys to believe me, but this Bunny guide that I made is tested and proven, especially in solo hard mode difficulty missions. It may not deal millions of damage, but it is more than enough to clear any content in the game, whether it's invasion missions, special operations, or even void intercept battle in a very acceptable amount of time. Now, I know that there are missions in the game that Bunny can't do efficiently, like for example Strategic Outpost missions, since only Sharon can efficiently do that type of mission, since the extra loot can only be obtained through stealth. I also know that there are builds out there that deal so much damage and can one-shot a specific boss. But here's the thing about those builds. Those are glass cannon builds that are specifically built to defeat a specific boss, and the moment you use that kind of build on a different content, then it is almost impossible. I have to say that glass cannon builds are fun, but the moment you get hit, you just go down right away. I don't want to spend my crystallization catalyst on a specific boss or content. I want a build that can do or almost do all content in the game without relying on my teammates or party members. With that out of the way, let's proceed to the build. For the first build, let's start with the build for invasion missions and special operations. This build can solo and clear these two types of mission easily in hard mode difficulty. I will always prioritize HP and defense first, since I really like tanky descendants, and then balance the damage and utility. Let's start with the reactor. I'm currently using a tingling phase reactor with an optimization condition, Nazeistra's Devotion. The most important stat here is the skill cost effect. This stat will help you manage the MP consumption or cost of speed of light. For the second stat, you can pick skill cooldown, skill effect range, or skill duration up, but always prioritize skill cost. For the auxiliary power, always go for double HP, then any bonus stat like module drop rate increase modifier or fire resistance if you are fighting a fire type boss, but always prioritize double HP stat. As long as you have the 2 HP stats on the auxiliary power, you are good to go. For the sensors, prioritize defense and max MP. The max MP stat will increase your MP pool significantly, and this will provide you with enough MP for speed of light. Depending on what you are doing, you can also go for character XP gain modifier if you are leveling a descendant, or you can also go for consumable drop rate increase modifier. If you are doing a void intercept battle and fighting a chill type or ice type boss, then go for a sensor with chill resistance. For the memory, go for double defense stat, and you can go for firearm proficiency gain modifier, gold drop rate increase modifier, or electric resistance. If you are doing void intercept battle or boss fights and you are fighting an electric type boss, go for the electric resistance, since it can lower the electric damage that you take. For the processor, prioritize defense, and then you can go for either equipment drop rate increase modifier, item acquisition distance increase modifier, or max shield. If you are doing void intercept battle and the boss is a toxic type, then go for the toxin resistance. For the modules, let's start with the best sub-module in the game, mid-air maneuvering. This is the best grappling hook module because you can grapple anywhere and reposition on the spot. For the health and defense modules, you can go for increased HP and increased defense. You can also go for HP amplification and shield conversion. With these two modules, it will increase your HP and defense a little bit, but at the cost of your shield. Me personally, I don't really care about shield since it is not affected by defense or any damage mitigation. These two are more than enough to survive endgame content like invasion missions and special operations missions. To increase the damage of lightning emission, I use power increase and skill simplification. To increase the range of lightning emission, I added skill expansion and maximize range, increasing the range of lightning emission by 186%. I also added skill extension, extending the duration of lightning emission from 20 seconds to 27 seconds. To reduce the speed of light MP cost, I added strong mentality and maximize conservation, which reduces skill cost by 50%. These two modules are going to improve the MP cost of speed of light. Last but not the least, I added MP collector, which recovers 12% of the max MP at 17% chance. Now, the proc chance may be low, but if you hit multiple enemies, the chances of proccing increases. If you are in a group or in a party, use MP collector and use HP collector if you are going solo. HP collector is one of the best survival modules in the game, providing you with 9% HP heal every time you kill an enemy with a 2-second cooldown. For the skill module, depending on whether you can afford to upgrade a transcendent module, go for high voltage. This module will increase the range and damage of lightning emission. For the weapons, I'm using Nazeistra's Devotion, Thunder Cage, and the Last Dagger. There is an in-depth guide for these weapons and links are in the description down below. For the inversion reinforcement, for the first slot, I used inversion particle augmentation, which increases defense by 7% for 30 seconds, stacking up to 5 stacks. Next is selective neurostimulation, which recovers MP every 60 seconds. And for the last slot, depending on the mission, I use secondary quantization response if I'm fighting against Legion of Immortality, biostructure decomposer for Order of Truth, and disable dark protocols for Legion of Darkness. Now, to be honest with you guys, the inversion reinforcement stats are really not that great, but since it is there, I might as well use it. Overall stats for this invasion and special operations build are the following. Firearm attack 73k, skill power as long as you're holding the Nazeistra's Devotion is 18k, defense 52k, max HP is 7k, and MP 322. This build, as I've said before, is more than enough for invasion missions and special operations, but there are times where you have to swap for tank build, which I will explain in a moment. For the tank build, this build is for void intercept battles or big boss fights. For the sub module, always use the mid-air maneuvering module. This is the best grappling hook module in the game. For the HP module, I'm using increased HP and HP amplification, increasing max HP by 445%. For the defense module, I'm using increased defense and shield conversion, increasing defense by 327%. HP amplification and shield conversion reduces your total shield, but as I've said, shields are not good because it is not affected by any defensive stats. Next are the ability modules. Power increase increases skill power by 65%. To improve the range, I use skill expansion and maximize range, increasing skill effect range by 186%. I also added skill extension to increase the duration of lightning emission from 20 seconds to 27 seconds. HP collector for more survivability. Lastly, maximize conservation, which reduces skill cost by minus 35%. For the skill module, you can use high voltage depending on the boss that you are fighting. If you are fighting the obstructor, then do not use high voltage since your job as Bunny is to destroy the small orbs escaping from the portal in the immune phase of the boss. The overall stats for the tank build is 73k firearm attack, 18k skill power, 83k defense, a measly 109 max shield, 11k max HP, and 430 max MP. Now, believe it or not, this is more than enough to do all the bosses in the game, but do not play like you are Rambo or the Terminator. This build will take a couple of point blank shotgun shots in the face before going down. Play smart and line of sight the boss's skill and abilities and try to strafe left and right. Just because this build has enough defense, it doesn't mean that you won't get knocked down. When engaging the enemies, use your grappling hook. It will proc your lightning emission faster and deal more damage since the move speed of the grappling hook is faster than running. If there are tough enemies like elites and you are close to the target, try to do a double jump and then press your melee attack to perform a ground slam. This attack will deal the double jump damage and deal area of effect damage from your melee attack. There will be invasion maps with invasion penalties such as this one. When hitting monsters with general rounds, outgoing damage modifier is reduced by -36%, which is insane. At first, I didn't notice the invasion penalties and died a couple of times. After noticing the penalty, all I had to do was swap to my tank build and then I was able to finish the invasion mission. My builds are there to solve problems like this one, and I know that there are probably better builds out there, but I can guarantee you that my builds can handle almost all the contents in the game. Also, do not get pressured if you make a mistake. Feel free to reset the run and do it over again. Also, do not hesitate to swap modules or use resistance modules or external components. Be smart and flexible with how you play the game. There is no shame in self-preservation. The bosses in this game doesn't care about your build, especially Gluttony, so play smart. Also, feel free to change the modules depending on what you want. This build is not set on stone, so do whatever you like. I hope this build is able to help you guys, and I hope that I won't see any more players complaining on Twitter that the game is hard and that they are getting one-shotted in invasion mission or any other content in the game. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.